Hey folks, we're going to have a quick overview of Stylism by Astute Graphics. First, what I want to do is draw a basic shape here on my artboard. With this basic shape, I actually want to apply some effects to it. So I'll come to the Tools panel and activate the Stylism tool. Then I'm going to come over to Window, find Stylism to bring up the Stylism panel. In this section of the panel, this is where you're able to apply the different effects onto your artwork. So now that I have my artwork selected, I want to add a drop shadow. So I click on this icon here and adds a drop shadow right away. If you look at the appearance panel, you can see it added the drop shadow here to the bottom of the stack. And when you click on the link, it brings up all the controls you're used to seeing. But now with Stylism, you actually don't need these controls anymore. You could use the annotation system you see on your artwork. So I could click and drag and it will change the offset for this drop shadow. I have a color chip here. When I click on it, it brings up my color picker, and I could change to a different color drop shadow if I'd like. I have these different blending modes I could choose from my the color of my drop shadow. This is going to affect the opacity. It's set at 75 by default, but if I bring it out to the edge, it'll bring it to 100%. And as I bring it closer towards the center, you see it drops the opacity all the way down towards zero. This one right here is going to control the blur. If I bring it closer towards the center, I could actually bring it down to zero and just have this nice sharp edge. I can click and drag and bring it towards the edge, and you see it's going to soften this out. Now if I click on this drop shadow link again, you see everything's been updated here for me, but it's done more intuitively using this annotation system with Stylism. I'll hide this appearance panel, and now I want to add this inner glow effect onto my artwork. So you see when I choose these different types of effects, I have different annotations. This one's still going to control the blur and opacity, but now I have the option of switching from the edge to the center, and you see it makes a dramatic effect on my artwork. If we look at the appearance panel, you see that that effect was added to the bottom of the stack. So I could just click and drag to target the fill if I'd like. Now, when I'm making adjustments, you see I have this inner glow activated at the moment. Well, if I want to make changes to my drop shadow again, I'll just click right here and I get this drop down menu. I'll find my drop shadow and I can make the changes here and here. And now that I've made my edits, if I want to go back and change the inner glow a bit, I have the option of doing that here by just clicking and dragging or changing this over to edge. And there you have it. If we look over here in the appearance panel again, you see that all the changes have been made for us automatically. And that's a quick overview of the Stylism tool by Astute Graphics.